Mike, we're delighted to have you here.
Thank you very much for being here. Thanks, Catherine.
So, should we be actually looking, Mike, at deploying doctors and nurses differently in order to better ensure the health of Canadians? Are we doing it the right way?
Well, you've just heard an example of the way population health has changed, and the kind of competencies and care that those folks require is different. But if you looked at the way the healthcare system is structured, I would say you'd be hard-pressed to see that much has changed since about the 1980s. So when we look, for example, at the way nurses are deployed, I have a colleague who's fond of saying you could drop Florence Nightingale into any hospital in the country and she'd know the routine, because it really hasn't changed very much.
Right.
In the meantime, we've educated the best educated nursing workforce in the history of this country. You would not know that if you saw the way nurses are deployed to work. So we spend about 15% of our public dollars on physicians, about 13% on the 400,000 nurses in the country. And I think, you know, we're having a look at the Canadian Nurses Association at how are we deploying those people to be most effective when population health has changed, long, long waits for primary care, long waits in emergency rooms, long waits for specialty care. Something isn't lining up.
So what needs to change?
Well, one of the solutions we talk about is how to deploy those nurses to provide some different kinds of care than they currently do. So let me give you a simple example. One is around, we've educated nurse practitioners. So we had, someone can tell me, I don't know if we had 100 in 2006, and they weren't regulated and so on. We now have more than 5,000 working across the country prescribing, you know, able to do a number of things for primary care that typically a GP would do. But we can also deploy the regular nursing workforce to do a great deal more of that. So I was in London recently and had a health problem that had been going on for some time with a cough. It was very interesting to go to a clinic led entirely by nurses.
Are you talking London, England?
London, England. Nurse-led clinic within the NHS, in the public system. All nurses, 200 patients a day, see you within 5 minutes of arrival, guaranteed to be finished within 2 hours. So there are models out there. We know that where nurses are very, very effective, we know that the care is safe. It's as effective for the patients and as satisfying for the same or less cost.
So why aren't we doing that here?
Well, there's a tremendous inertia, I think, around the kinds of competencies within the physician group and the nurse group, and I mean registered nurses, practical nurses, terrible inertia in trying to let some of that go. And my view would be that we have to understand nobody owns a competency, right? Many people can learn it. So we've scaled up our physicians a great deal, scaled up RNs to some degree, but we have a very long way to go. And you know, I tell young students often, we forget there was a time when nurses couldn't do blood pressures and give injections. And when that was going to happen, there was a huge uproar that was going to be the end of the healthcare system. So nurses, the idea that nurses want to be docs or mini docs is wrong. We want to expand nursing practice to provide more primary care and so on. The great example in Toronto, and I'm pleased to see Maureen McTeer here, who was the co-chair of the National Expert Commission. And we discovered this study during our work in 2011-2012, where the emergency room was very crowded at Toronto Western, and like they are across the country, big tertiary care hospital. And they noticed that they had a lot of old folks, typical also of emergency rooms, long waits in hallways on stretchers and so on. And they simply did a small study and asked the question, what if we sent the nurse out versus bringing the patient in? In that 1 year study, 80% of those transfers would have been eliminated and a 20% savings in the cost. So one of the things we said at the time was, why don't we just replicate that model right across the country, since emergency room wait times is such a huge thing. It simply has not spread, and it seems to be a really intractable problem. And it's not a doc versus nurse thing. We have it within nursing. Practical nurses, you know, their scope has increased, their competence even have increased. So we think there's a lot of room to deploy those 500,000 nurses and docs differently for that high cost.
There's clearly more to this discussion. Maybe we could do an entire show on this. But thank you.